Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue with addition subtraction of fractions, but before we do that, let us close our eyes, observe a minute silence, and pray for peace within and outside us. So till now, what we have done how to add fractions, we have done how to subtract fraction, and now what we'll do today, if we have to add and subtract in one question only. Till now what we have done, either we have added or we have subtracted. So this time what we are going to do, in one question we are going to add as well as we are going to subtract. So before we come to fraction, let us revise what we have done in the previous classes. We have done it with the whole numbers, yes, and for that what you people have used, you have used DMAS, yes, which says if it is division, then divide first, then multiply, add, and then subtract. And when you people have done this, so actually what you have done for whole numbers, that we arrange it, isn't it? Because we say we add first and then we subtract. So let's arrange it. Arrange means we take the positive numbers together, which is plus and this, so we'll write 45 plus 10 first, and then we'll write minus 15, isn't it? So what will happen? We are going to add first and then we'll subtract. So this becomes 55 minus 15. So we have added first according to DMAS and then we'll subtract. So now subtract, this will be 40. So the answer is 40, isn't it? This is what we have done. Now we are going to follow the same procedure, and this time we are going to take fractions. So we are going to start with, as we have done in the previous classes, that we first take like fractions, we solve them, and then we'll take the case for unlike fractions, and then we'll solve it. So let's take first like fractions. So as we can see that the denominators are same. So if the denominators are same, then what we can say that these fractions are like fractions, and if they are like fractions, then yes, we can add and subtract them. Now second thing what we have to do is, first is this, we have checked that they are like fractions. Now the second thing that we have to do is, we have to check are they arranged or not. So this time they are arranged, two positive numbers are together and this minus is here. So now we are going to follow the same procedure as we have done for addition and subtraction, that we can simply write the denominator here, the and all the numerators over it. So this is 7 plus 5 minus 4. Okay, so what we have done, this denominator 9 is common, and all the numerators along with the operation is here. So we'll first add these two first. So 7 plus 5 is 12 minus 4, and this 12 minus 4 is 8 upon 9. Isn't it easy? So 8 upon 9 is the single fraction that we are looking for. Now we'll check whether we can further solve it or not. So no need to further solve it. This is in the simplest form. So this is the answer. Now let's take something in which you have to do calculations. So this time I am taking unlike fractions. Okay, so now what we'll do, the first thing that you have to do whenever you have to add or subtract is to first convert these mixed fractions to improper fractions. So we'll do that. So this is 6 6 is 36 plus 5 is 41 upon 6 minus this is 12 plus 1 13 upon 4 plus 3 by 2. And now the second step is to arrange them. Arrange them means this is plus plus, so we'll write them together and subtraction we'll do at the end. So we'll write 41 upon 6 plus 3 upon 2 minus 13 upon 4. So this is arranged now. Now the procedure is again the same. We'll find out the LCM. LCM of the denominator, so LCM of 6, 2 and 4. So LCM of 6, 2 and 4 is 12. So the denominator, common denominator will be 12. Now what you have to do, you have to change your numerators. Now change the numerators. Now this is 41. So by which number I should multiply 41? It's 6. So 6 2's is 12. 6 2's is 12. So this will be multiplied by 2 plus 3. So this 3, 2, so see the denominator, 2 6 is 12. 2 6 is 12. So this 3 will be multiplied by 6. Now minus sign, so put the minus sign. Then 13 multiplied by, it's 4. So 4, 3 is 12. So 13 will be multiplied by 3. Now solve it. So this is 12. This will be 82. 41 into 2 will be 82. Plus this will be 18 minus this will be 39. Now again write the denominator 12. Now add these two numbers. This will be 2 and 8, 10, 9 and this will be 100 minus 39. Now solve it. First we have added and now we subtract. So this is 12. So this is 0, 9. So this will become 1 and this will become 9. So 9 minus 3 will be 6. 61 upon 12. Now we have the single fraction. Can we further reduce it or cancel it? So we cannot cancel it. There is no factor that is common. But since it's an improper fraction, so we can convert it to mixed fraction. So 60 means by 5. So 5 whole 1 upon 12. So the answer of this is 5 whole 1 upon 12. So we can again quickly just check what we have done. So what we have done in here, we have first converted these mixed fraction to improper fraction. Then the most important step is to, though you'll get the answer even if you don't arrange it, but it is better that you arrange it. If you arrange it, then you get the correct answer. Okay. So we have first arranged it. We have taken the positive number together and then the negative number, so that my calculation become easy. Now take the LCM of the denominator as we have done in all the cases. So LCM of the denominator is 12. Now write 12 as common denominator. Then 6, 2's is 12. So 41 into 2. Then 6 and then 3. Now further solve it. Then you come up with the first add. Then you subtract. Then you come up with the single fraction. Now check whether you can reduce it. And yes, we have converted it to mixed.